Welcome to ePaathshala lecture series on computer science. Today we are going to discuss about the paper Cryptography and Network Security. In this paper we are going to start with the first module, introduction about cryptography. Learning objectives: in this particular introduction module we are going to discuss about to understand the definition of cryptography and network security, to understand the need for cryptography, to know the basic terms related with cryptography, to know the importance of cryptography in various fields. Keywords are cryptography, security, keys, encryption and decryption. First, we are going to discuss about what is security. So, what is security? Security is state of being free from danger or threats. So, what is threats? Where you need the security is a kind of requirement for any kind of network related activity or computer related activity. Something is going to be happening for a particular system or an internet, how we are going to protect that? That is what we are going to discuss in the case of this whole lecture series. Security is the ability of the system to protect the information and system resources with respect to confidentiality and integrity. So, confidentiality and integrity are the more important component of any secure system, where we want to ensure that that should be handled in proper manner. In that way where you can helping the system. So, what are the different types of security related with that? One is we have a computer security, another one is network security, another one is internet security. The whole lecture components where we are going to deal with these securities, where the computer security is the generic name for collecting of tools designed to protect or the threat with hackers. So, generally if we take a particular computer user, if they are going to use a computer in proper manner, then we do not need any kind of security. If suppose your computer is going to be affected by virus, how we are going to protect that? Or some malware or some kind of spyware gets installed into a system. In that case, how we are going to protect that? That things are deals with your computer security. Network security, measure to protect the data during the transmission. The previously where we discussed about computer security, in that computer security where we deal only with the individual system or a particular laptop. Suppose if an attacker is gaining the control, suppose I am going to connect the system to an internet where it need to provide a security solution for the transmission of data. So, how I am going to protect the data during the transmission? So, what way the attacker can able to steal your information during the transmission of the data? So, when a system is going to be within your control, no problem. In that case, we can able to protect your system. If a data is going to be sending out over a transmission, unsecure transmission channel, how we are going to protect that? That things are going to be deal with the help of your network security. Next, internet security. The measure to protect data during the transmission over the collection of interconnected network. It is very much important for today's world, where most of the users will be sending their personal data or sensitive information. Even for an example, suppose I am going for a e-transaction, when I am going to purchase some product through an e-commerce website, where I need to provide the payment for a particular product, where I am going to send my data over the internet. What is an internet? Internet is nothing but it is a interconnection of various networks, either can have a LAN or a WAN or even different LANs and different WANs and different ISP providers, even various servers. So, in that case, how I am going to protect my data in the internet? That is the thing where you are going to deal with your internet security. So, in the case of your security, we have to concentrate how we are going to provide your security solution for your computer, network, internet. So, that is what the whole idea behind this particular topic. So, how we are going to provide the security solution? The next question comes in our mind, right? So, first thing where we want to protect our system, second thing I want to protect the data over the transmission, third thing whatever the activity I do on the internet, how I am going to protect it. So, one solution what we have right now here is cryptography. What is cryptography? A cryptography is nothing but generally we can say it is a process of writing or reading secret messages or code. What is writing or reading secret messages or code? So, when I am going to show you are going to make you to read off particular content, if you are able to read it, then it is not secure. So cryptography is nothing but art of hiding the things. Though the you can able to view the particular letters or character, but it is very difficult for you to understand that particular thing. So it is very important in the component of your network security, computer security, as well as your internet security. Another point where we are discussing about cryptography is art of protecting the information by transforming it, encrypting it into an unreadable format called cipher text. So what we are going to do, how we are going to make it out? We are going to convert the plain text into cipher text. That process is explained in the case of your cryptography as encryption, encrypting the things. So whatever it going to be sent, either it may be stored in your system, or it is going to be sent over internet, or it is going to be transmitted over a network connection, wherever you are going to transmit your data, everything is going to be in the encrypted format. Usually we call that as a cipher text. So cipher text means unreadable. Nobody can able to read the particular content unless until if they have the method or the particular thing, it is able to do it. Why we want to go for cryptography? As already mentioned, a feature designed to detect, prevent or recover from security attacks. What is security attacks? Security attacks means either deliberately or unknowingly a particular person trying to gain a control of a particular system or a particular network. That is what we say in the case of your attack. So here cryptography is one of the solution where it can able to prevent or able to detect such a kind of activity which is going to be happening in your network. But the solution is no single mechanism that will support all the security requirement. That is very important in the case of your security. No single mechanism. If suppose I want to protect my data, I can't do it with a single method. I need to have some sort of more than one mechanism or a combination of more mechanism to support to overcome the issues related with security. However, one particular element underlying many of the security mechanism what we are going to discuss is cryptographic techniques. So we are going to discuss what are the techniques first initially, which are the techniques are suitable for which kind of application. So what are the techniques are available, how we are going to overcome that, how we are going to understand that, where you need to apply which technique, because it is not going to be a single technique. How I am going to study of each and every technique, where I need to use each and every technique in my system, that is very important in order to learn about the cryptography. This slide explains about what is the current trend in the security threats. So we know what is threats, right? Threats means danger. Threats means a kind of danger, either it is causing to a system or it is going to cause it to a network or it is going to cause it to a. So as we can able to see that the percentage wise they have been differentiated various kinds of threats. The first high level threats is spyware, right? So spyware is somebody trying to spying into your machine without your knowledge. That is what we say as a spyware. Spyware where it is going to gain your system as entering as a spy into your system. So when you consider this case where it is going to be most of the threats when compared, it is going to be one of the most prominent and also very difficult to identify that kind of threat. That is what it is taking more than 50% of your threats. Other things are awareness, user awareness, where the lack in the user awareness, virus swarms, unauthorized user abuses, browser based attacks, remote access, wireless network security, like that we can list out many kind of threats. So among them we are going to know about what kind of threats may happening in the day to day life. If you know about that threats, then only we can apply our cryptographic technique. If you know the cryptographic technique, then we should know how to apply which technique is suitable for what kind of threats. That is what we want to know. Before going to start with the thing of security, where we want to know about very applications related with security, where I can use cryptography or network security, where I need to go for cryptography. In that case, it is going to be applied in the case of when I am going to look into a web content, how I am going to protect my web content. When it is transmitted over a internet, how I am going to protect it. In that case, where we discuss about web content, email communication, day to day life activity, each and every user, each and every individual have an email account. So how I am going to protect the email content? e-commerce application, most commonly, most of the most popular thing nowadays were emerging with the e-commerce, where everyone is doing shopping over the internet. Remote login. What is the remote login? Remote login is a kind of system configuration where they are going to do it from the remote location. Suppose I am going to have my system in some other location where I want to configure it or maintain the system or troubleshooting the particular system, I never go to the particular location. I will be stay wherever through an internet connection I will do the configuration. For example, if you go for a network router or switches, in that case I will go for remote login. So, when I am going for remote login, then it is easy for me to configure the device without traveling all the way to that particular device. So, it is another important thing where we need to do provide a security in that particular feature, because if somebody is capturing the control of your device, they can able to control your entire network. That is very important one. Another point nowadays we can discuss about storing of your data in the internet. How we are going to store the data, right? So, storing a data where you can see cloud is one of the emerging technology where you can have cloud storage, where I am going to store all my data. For example, if you take a Google Drive or if you take a Hotmail OneDrive, everybody can store their document over internet. So, when I am storing the document in the internet, how it is going to be protected from unauthorized access? If it is within your system, no problem, nobody can able to gain control unless until they take your device. Otherwise, if it is going to be on online, I am going to store all my data in an online, how I am going to protect it, how I am going to provide the privacy, how I am going to provide the security or encryption, or what mechanism I can emphasize in the case of protecting my data. That is also one of the important application. Then finally, we have a banking transaction. So, we know very well everybody is going for an online banking. So, how important to have protecting the account information, transaction information, all the related banking activities should be protected. So, these are the fields where you can come out with a network security. How I am going to protect all this from the unauthorized access or a threats or an attack. With this, we are entering into our security. We are going to find out the solution for each and every applications or kind of attacks or threats going to be the system. Okay. First thing, we need to understand security key concept. This diagram where you can able to see that there are three words which is very prominent in the security world. One is confidentiality, another one is integrity, another one is availability. In the center of this triad, okay, usually we call this as a CIA triad. CIA triad means confidentiality, integrity, availability. As we can see into the particular triangle, in center of that we have a data and services, two important things of our internet activity, data or services. Suppose I want to check my mail, it's a data. What is the service is going to providing? Email service. So, I need to provide email service with confidentiality. I need to provide email service with integrity. I need to provide email service with availability. So, if you think of a data also, I need to provide the data with confidentiality, I need to provide the data with integrity, I need to provide the data with availability. So, these three are the important things. In addition to that, we are going to discuss about what are the various other security services. So, what is confidentiality? First thing, what is confidentiality? Confidentiality means assures that private or confidential information is not made available or disclosed to unauthorized individuals. So, what is that unauthorized individuals? Somebody is willing to see your email. So, easily they can able to get into your email if they know your username and password. If they gain your username and password, they can able to see that. If they don't have the email username password of your own, what they will do? They try to capture all your information over an internet. If suppose I am going to send the email over an internet, what will happen? If it is not encrypted, that means it is a readable form of plain data, then your data is not going to be confidential. So, suppose I want to send email to a friend, if another friend want to know what is the conversation between these two persons, they try to capture over a internet. If I am not providing the confidentiality, then there is no meaning of sharing the secret between the two users. So, it is very important we need to provide the confidentiality. Confidentiality means non-disclosure of your information. How we are going to protect? Even though if a friend is willing to know about your information, how I am going to protect that information? So, this is what confidentiality. Next one is privacy. What is privacy? Assures that individual control or influence what information related to them may be collected and stored by whom and to whom the information may be disclosed. So, privacy means if suppose something is very sensitive to me. So, this best example where you can take in the case of your medical record. So, medical record, suppose somebody, some hospital, they never disclose any of the medical secrets to somebody. So, the privacy need to be maintained on behalf of the patient. So, if they are willing to see other, nowadays most important role of privacy in the field of social media. Most of our having an account in your Facebook or Twitter. So, where somebody is trying to enter into your privacy, that is what each and every time when they are be as kind of an activity, we need to protect our privacy. So, whom to view your content, how much privilege you are going to give to the unknown user. All these things, why they are bringing into the thing is because it is very sensitive information. Your personal data should not be revealed to any of the unknown authorized persons. That is very important. So, we have to take care of that privacy. Integrity. What is integrity, right? That is, here we may given as data integrity and system integrity. What is integrity? So, integrity means there should not be any modification of data during the transmission. Suppose I am transmitting an information, suppose again you take a same example of email, I want to share it with my friend, where I am stating that, okay, tomorrow we are going out for some personal related activity. So, and they are giving some address where to come, in that way they are going to sending the mail. If somebody is capturing the mail and changing the address during the transmission of the data and again it is sending to the particular user, then there is an issue related with the integrity. So, integrity where you should not allow any unauthorized user to modify your content during the transmission. So, there are two kind of integrity. One is data integrity, as what we can able to see that assures that information and program are changed only in authorized manner, data integrity. Another one is system integrity, assures that the system performs its intended function free from deliberate or inadvertent unauthorized manipulation. So, these are the two important components of your integrity. The next one is availability. What is availability means? Availability means make the things available to each and every user who are intended for that particular service. For example, from tomorrow onwards, there will not be going to be any Gmail service, somebody is saying, or due to some reason for 1 week, there will not be any Gmail service. Or there is no internet service related with that, there is no banking service. So, what will happen if the server is going to be down? If it is intentionally done, for example, for maintenance purpose, they are doing, no problem. In the case, the availability where it can be done. If somebody attacker trying to attack the particular server and make the service will not be available for another user, then the availability need to be considered. So, in that case, where the availability is going to be one of the important service of our security. So, availability means assures the system works promptly and service is not denied to the authorized user. So, who are authorized to get the particular service, definitely the availability has to be made it available in the security system. So, aspect of security, why I need to discuss all this thing, what is the need for security? The aspect of information security is, one is very important thing is security attack. So, how I am going to consider the attack over my machine? As I said, availability. What kind of attack can be done? For example, somebody want to stop my internet service, ISP provider, they are going to attack it, or some server I am going to maintain for a particular university or particular college. Somebody intentionally want to stop the service of that. So, these kind of things we consider as a security attack, and the protection to that particular security attack we will consider as a mechanism and what way we are going to provide that with the help of your service. Security attack. What is an attack? Any action that compromise the security of information owned by the organization. So, any action, what did they are doing to compromising the security? I say, okay, I have a well secured environment. Nobody can able to enter into my system. If I say, if somebody is compromising that, okay, for example, I am protecting my server with kind of a firewall, an attacker can do some kind of programming where they can able to bypass the firewall and again they can able to get into that. So, that intentionally, deliberately they want to enter into the system, we say that is going to be attack. Information security is about how to prevent that attack or failing that to detect an attack on the information based system. So, either I can go for preventing that or I go for detecting, at least minimum I have to detect the kind of an attack. Instead of going for preventing measure, if a kind of an attack is going to be happening in my system, kindly we have to go for detecting the particular attack, how to detect the particular attack. So, before going to think about the detecting the attack, we have to know what are the kinds of attacks are going to be happening in your system. So, mainly we have two generic types of attack, one is passive attack, another one is active attack. So, what is a passive attack? What is an active attack? So, from this particular figure where you can able to understand what do you mean by passive attack. Passive attack means who will be present in your system, but we are unaware of that particular person. We are not able to distinguish whether you are under an attack or not an attack, because the attacker never do any kind of modification or changes to your system. Simply they will be monitoring your system, they will be keep on observing what is happening between the two users. As per this diagram where you can able to see that there are two persons, one is Bob, another one is Alice, where they were involved in a conversation. There is another person who is a attacker, is in the man in the middle, who is intercepting, right. So, intercepting just reading the content of message from Bob to Alice, that is the intention of the person. He is not doing any attack over the particular system, he is just monitoring what is happening between this Bob and this is called passive attack. Another kind of passive attack is traffic analysis. Traffic analysis, what is traffic here? Traffic is deals with a kind of an activity between the two user. What is the network traffic? What data is going to be transmitted between two user? How they are going to accessing? What kind of packets are traveling over a network? How it is going to be attacking? How it's going to be sent in a particular user manner? That way, here you can able to see that traffic analysis. They want to know what kind of traffic is happening in the network. Either it may be for good intent, good sense or in bad sense, that is different. But the case is here, this passive attacks can be turned into a active attack. That is very difficult and also very dangerous when you are going to consider in the case of your cryptography. Next, active attack. What is an active attack? The person who is going to create some kind of modification over your system. Though you are going to have a secure environment, his intention is to attack your system. He want to do some kind of danger or threats to your system. In that manner, first one what we have in this particular diagram is interruption. Interruption means my aim is to stop the service between the two user. I do not want to simply monitoring, I do not want to analyze the traffic. My aim is to making the traffic between two user going to be interrupted. So, as what here, another one is fabrication. Fabrication means what I will do after receiving the message, where I will do the changes in the message and I will replay the particular, usually this called as an replay attack. Replay attack means as what I mentioned in the case of your email, first I will take the email, I will read that email, wherever I want to change it, I will simply change it, I will send back to the intended user. So, what will happen? The receiver never know about whether it is transmitted as original message of the Bob or it is modified by the Darth. That is what the thing. So, as what this diagram you can able to see that when Bob is sending the message, Darth is the man in the middle who is capturing that message and reading the content of the message. After that he is modifying and it is sending to the Alice. Now, Alice does not have any knowledge about whether the message is modified during the transmission. Replay attack also in the same manner, instead of sending the modified content where Bob will sending a message where Darth is taking a message and he will be replaying the message later, not immediately. Fabrication he will do immediately after receiving the message, immediately he goes for sending the message with some small changes. But replay attack, where he take the message later sometime, he will be sending that to the Alice. That is the thing, capturing the message from Bob to Alice, later the replay message to the Alice. Modification, during the modification, where it is going to be modifying the message and send back to the users without involvement of both the users. So, what we understand from these attacks, passive attack and active attack. When you consider passive attack and active attack, which is more dangerous? Which is more dangerous in the sense here, how it is going to affect your secure environment? In the case where we can say that passive attack are more dangerous because we are not able to detect or we cannot able to prevent that kind of passive attack. But active attack, immediately we can able to understand and we can able to provide some security mechanism to overcome this kind of an attack. So, now we see that how we are handling this kind of attack. So, passive attacks focusing on prevention, where we want to only preventing that, we do not want to make the people to read our email, we do not want the people to analyze our traffic, we do not want the unauthorized people to enter that. So, here it is easy to stop, but hard to detect. When there is a passive attack, it is very very hard to detect because they are not doing any kind of changes over your message content. Simply they are monitoring. So, it is very very difficult for you to detect. Whereas, in the case of your active attack, where you can able to see that focuses on detection and recovery. What is they are saying in this here? Hard to stop, easy to detect. So, there you can say the controversy, right? Where we say passive attack are hard to detect. Here we can say it is easy to detect. What does it mean? Here easily you can detect, but the easy hard to stop, which is hard to stop? Active attack. Why it is hard to stop? Because their intention is to attack your system, but in passive attack they never do anything danger to your system, but they simply monitoring. So, easily we can able to stop it, but it is very very difficult to detect that particular attack. So, how we are going to provide or the solution to stop or detect or recovery a system when it is going to be under an attack? That is what we have in the case of your security services. So, security services, where it is going to enhance the security of data processing system and information transfer for an organization, where it is intention to counter the security attacks and one or more security mechanism, where they have lots of mechanism associated with often replicating function normally associated with your physical document. So, these are the various way we can able to provide the security. So, what are the types of security? Already we have discussed about CIA, confidentiality, integrity, availability. In addition, here we have an authenticity and non-repudiation. Confidentiality, what is confidentiality? We say encrypting the content during the transmission. So, nobody can able to see that particular content. And integrity, okay, we can able to detect the provide the mechanism to detect the changes during your content, verifying the detect the contraction of the content. Availability, where it is making the things going to be available. So, here as we are having authenticity and non-repudiation, what is authenticity? Authenticity, where it is going to ensure that only authorized user can able to enter into your system. Non-repudiation, yes, it is related with your e-commerce, where we can able to say that in the e-commerce, when a particular user going to purchase a product from the seller, seller later on he cannot deny that I didn't purchase or I didn't sold a particular product to that particular, I didn't taken the money from the particular user. So, in that case, we are going for non-repudiation. Non-repudiation means later on you should not deny. Once you done the particular thing, later on you should not able to deny the particular thing. So, as how we are going to ensure these things, right? One is confidentiality, one is integrity, another one is non-repudiation. As what we can able to see that your message is going to be send as an encrypted as a secret information, where you can see that confidentiality. Next, we can able to see that here it is not going to be sent in an open channel, it is going to be sent in the closed channel. And finally, non-repetition, where it is going to be ensured with the help of third party. So, nobody can able to gain the control or they cannot deny later on whether this sender and receiver has not agreed with any kind of transaction. So, with this we will come to the conclusion of this particular session, where we are going to discuss about summary. What are the things we have discussed? different definition of cryptography and also various attacks related to the cryptography and applications related to the network security and model for network security, and finally we explored various fields where you can come out with a cryptography. Thank you.